So we're going to use Terraform with AWS. So the first thing I'm going to cover here is actually making sure we have AWS configured for ourselves here. So we have some instructions here on installing the AWS CLI version 2 command line tool here. I'm in Mac OS because that's what I'm using. And essentially what it boils down to is just running a few commands to install this. Here you curl and download a .pkg file, and then you run the installer command to install that .pkg file. Now I already have the AWS command line here. It's actually not the latest. I have 2.1.5, but I actually don't think this is the latest. There's a newer version than this. So I can rerun these instructions to get the latest. So I'm going to do that curl command to download the .pkg file. And then we can do sudo, because I want to install this for all users on my computer. Installer, it's a package type, and it's the AWS CLI v2.package file and target with the root. Put in my password, and it's doing its thing. Okay, the upgrade was successful. So AWS version, it's now 2.1.21. So I have the latest stable. So you can just run those commands and get the latest version. And I'm just going to go ahead and remove this .pkg file. Okay, so AWS is there. If you have never done that on your own computer and you don't have the AWS command line tools, then you can run AWS configure to go ahead and have it configure and set up some things for you. What it'll do is create a .aws directory inside of your home directory for your current user, and it'll create config and credentials. So if we check out config, we'll see it has some defaults for certain profiles. So I have a bunch of profiles here just from my years of usage for the AWS, and we can see it just has output of JSON for a default and a region US East 1 or US East 2, depending on the project I have, for a default region to use. Now, I won't show you the credentials file, but I will say I have a profile set up for credentials. Within the credentials file, you'll have a default configuration, and you just set an AWS key and secret for access credentials, permissions to call methods against the AWS API. In my case, I have a profile set up for Cloudcast specifically. It just has that same bracket notation, and underneath this bracket notation in that credentials file is a key and a secret key, which I can't show you here, which gives me permissions to do stuff in that account. So of course, I actually need permission to make resources on my AWS account. So if we sign into the console here, we'll head to security credentials. And I have a user here that I'm using for accounts here. So basically to create a new user, you can create one for programmatic access, not console access. And of course you need to set permissions. So I think what I do is attach existing policies directly and I give administrator access. Now, of course, this is a lot of access. It's basically access to everything in the AWS account. So how you want to handle this off the bat is up to you. So this is the easiest way to give administrator access to your user. You can also follow the principle of least privilege, but Terraform tends to touch a lot of things in your account. So many things that you may just give administrator account, or you effectively do anyway, depending on how sprawling your resources are. Now, there are other ways to manage this, but we're not going to get into that just yet. We're just going to do administrator access here to start, which is what I already have set up in my AWS account. Okay, so that's configured already for me. My AWS credentials are there. I'm using a profile called Cloudcast, and now we can see how to install Terraform. And installing Terraform is just brew tap HashiCorp tap. Of course, this is Mac OS specific. It's different for Linux and others, but just as simple. And then brew install HashiCorp tap Terraform. And then later to update it, you brew upgrade HashiCorp tap Terraform. Let's actually try that right now. I think I have the latest, but we'll see. Okay, it's already installed, so I have the latest 0.14.3 as of this recording. So in the next video, we'll start configuring our Terraform infrastructure as code configuration here to use with my Cloudcast AWS account, and we can get started seeing how Terraform works.